It's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord yet again.
Amen.
That on this day, together, we can celebrate the birth of Jesus. As I was spending some time in contemplation this week, I came across a quote that said this. It says that, "Blessed is the season in which the whole world engages in a conspiracy of love." When you think about that, it doesn't matter if you believe in Jesus Christ or if you do not believe, you are caught up in a light that the world itself cannot comprehend. The Bible tells us very specifically that He will use the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. And when we think about this virgin birth that we celebrate every year, it's foolish to our minds. It makes no sense. But it shows that we have a God that cares so much about us that He disrobed Himself and presented Himself in the earth's realm purely for our benefit. So we are here to praise His glory, not just today, but every day. We can't go through this season without first inspecting our own mortality. And I look at the faces in the room and I know that most of us have done that at some point this past year. But we get to this precipice of time in which we celebrate the hope that Jesus Christ has implanted in us. That regardless of what happens, regardless of what we have to go through, regardless of what we have to experience, that even we might not live another day, but we are here to enjoy this moment. How special is that? So I think to open up the service today, we'll go with the lectionary reading coming from John chapter 1. Simply says this, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of man. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light, the true light that gives light to every man that was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born of not of natural descent, nor of human descent or decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John testifies concerning him. He cries out, saying, 'This was he of whom I said, he who comes after me surpassed me because he was before me.' From the fullness of his grace we have all received one blessing after another. For the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but the God, the one and only who is at the Father's side, has made him known." Man, such powerful words, especially as many of us, we shared in a celebration on Christmas night. And at the end of that service, we took from the Advent candle a burning flame and we passed it around the room. That light which represents the love that God bestowed on us when he gave us his son. So as we continue through this service today and we have a beautiful celebration and we have the babies and the music that is amongst us, let us not forget the real reason why we're here. And let us not forget what we should carry with us once we leave here. Amen.